Hello everyone and welcome to another video on ECG. In today's video, we are going to discuss an important condition which is commonly encountered in emergency department, especially in patients with acute ST elevation MI. This is accelerated idioventricular rhythm. So by the end of the video, you will be able to understand the mechanism of accelerated idioventricular rhythm, the ECG features, management, and at the end of the video, we will discuss some ECG examples of accelerated idioventricular rhythm. Before starting the discussion, let me give you a brief introduction of myself. I am Dr. Vajid Shabir. I have done residency in cardiology and currently working as a registrar cardiology. And if you are a medical professional interested in learning ECG, you should subscribe to this channel so you could stay updated with the videos. So let's begin the discussion. First of all, what is accelerated idioventricular rhythm? Accelerated idioventricular rhythm results when the rate of an ectopic ventricular pacemaker exceeds that of sinus rhythm. This rhythm is often associated with increased vagal tone and decreased sympathetic tone. Now the mechanism of AIVR. The proposed mechanism of AIVR is enhanced automaticity of ventricular pacemaker, although some may say that trigger activity play an important role, especially in case of ischemia or those with digoxin toxicity. So this type of arrhythmia is classically seen in reperfusion phase of acute ST elevation MI, especially in patients who are thrombolyzed. It is usually a well-tolerated, benign, self-limiting arrhythmia, and it is also known as accelerated ventricular rhythm. Now next is the ECG features. The ECG features of AIVR includes a regular rhythm. The rate is between 50 to 110 beats per minute. And there should be three or more consecutive ventricular complexes. The QRS complexes should be more than 120 milliseconds in duration, and there should be presence of fusion beats and capture beats in case of AIVR. Now, an important feature of AIVR is isorhythmic AV dissociation. This refers to AV dissociation with sinus and ventricular complexes occurring at identical rates. There are multiple conditions in which you see AV dissociation. For example, in heart block or in case of ventricular tachycardia. But the difference between the AV dissociation in heart block or VT and between AIVR is that in this case, the rate of sinus and ventricular complexes are identical. While in case of complete heart block, the atrial rate will be more than ventricular rate, while in case of ventricular tachycardia, it will be opposite, means that the ventricular rate will be more than atrial rate. This isorhythmic AV dissociation is usually due to functional block at the AV node due to retrograde ventricular impulses. These impulses depolarize the AV node, leaving it refractory to incoming sinus impulses. Now, next is ventricular rate. Ventricular rate is an important thing which differentiates AIVR from ventricular escape rhythm and ventricular tachycardia. In case of AIVR, as I earlier mentioned, that heart rate is about 50 to 110 beats per minute. In cases where the heart rate is less than 50 beats per minute and there are features of origin of rhythm from ventricle, this is called ventricular escape rhythm. While in cases where the heart rate is more than 110 beats per minute, it is consistent with ventricular tachycardia. Now, next is causes of AIVR. There are multiple causes of AIVR, but the most important is rifampin phase of acute myocardial infarction, especially after thrombolysis. And it is a very specific sign of rifampin. So AIVR can also occur with beta agonists such as isoprenaline or adrenaline in case of drug toxicity, especially with digoxin, cocaine, and anesthetics, and some of anesthetics. It could result from electrolyte abnormalities, cardiomyopathy, congenital diseases, also with a return of spontaneous circulation after a cardiac arrest. Also, it can occur physiologically in patients who are athletes. So, what is the management of AIVR? AIVR is usually a benign rhythm and it does not require any treatment. Usually self-limiting, and it resolves when the sinus rate exceeds that of ventricular foci. And there is no use of administration of antiarrhythmic drugs. Usually treating the cause such as electrolyte imbalance or restoration of myocardial perfusion result in return of sinus rhythm. However, in cases of low cardiac output states, such as in patients with severe biventricular dysfunction, we can benefit with restoration of sinus rhythm with administration of medication such as atropine, which increase in atrial rate and results in increased conduction through AV node and suppression of AIVR. Now, this was brief discussion on mechanism, the causes, and management of AIVR. Next, we will see some ECG strips, and we try to find out what are the findings on an ECG with AIVR. So this is a 12-lead ECG. You can see that there are some sinus rhythm. If you look at the first beat in rhythm strip at the bottom of the ECG, there is a P wave followed by narrow QRS complex. But after this, there are four complexes with wide QRS complex, and the rate is around 60 beats per minute. So this is basically due to competing sinus and idioventricular pacemaker. Also, after these four wide QRS complexes, you can see two sinus beats. These are called capture beats. So this was basically ECG of a 33-year-old marathon runner, and it was possibly due to increased vagal tone. Here there is another ECG. Initially, if you look at the rhythm strip, initially from the left side, there are three beats with P wave preceding each beat and narrow QRS complexes. Then there are two wide QRS complexes at a rate of 60 beats per minute. Also, there is isorhythmic dissociation present with captured beats and a fusion beat. This is the fusion beat. It is formed by the union of a normal sinus beat and a ventricular ectopic beat. Now, here in this strip, the ventricular beats, the captured beats, and fusion beats are shown in zoomed image. So here is another example of accelerated idioventricular rhythm, where you can see that there are broad complexes at a rate of about 90 beats per minute, but there are no P waves. So by definition, if any rhythm which is of ventricular region and it lies between 50 to 110 beats per minute, it is called accelerated idioventricular rhythm. Although there are no capture beats, no fusion beats, and P waves are hardly visible. So this is all for today. Hopefully you like the video. For more videos, kindly subscribe to this channel. And if you like the video, please don't forget to mention in the comment. Allah Hafiz and take care till next time.